The blessings of our sweet Jesus in his company be with you, heart dwellers. Well, I've been getting hit with all kinds of distractions, one after the other, and I wasn't recognizing that they were distractions until my husband brought it to my attention. Thank God for my husband. He has the anointing to see right through what the enemy's trying to do. The Lord has something very specific he wants me to do, and the moment I got serious about doing it, I was slammed out of left field with distractions. Powerful distractions, like dropping everything and stocking up on food for the left behind, getting involved in community dramas. Now, I suspected it was a distraction, but Ezekiel knew it. And one after another, for the last 3 days, I've been getting hit with those. Finally, my husband and the Lord have brought me back to my senses, and I can see what's been going on. Precious heart dwellers, some of you are writing to me with heart-rending letters asking for guidance from me, and it just breaks my heart. There are so many letters, we can't answer them all, and I can't do it. I just can't answer them. The Lord has asked me to do a specific task, and I have to complete it, and there is no time beyond the time it takes me to just eat, sleep, live, and work on what he's asked me to do. Ezekiel and I have wept over some of your situations, how very painful they are. And the Lord has assured us, as we take care of what he has asked us to do, he will take care of you. Know that my heart is with you. Please, I ache and groan for you, but only Jesus can give you the answer and solve your dilemma. Know that time is extremely short and wrapping up right before your eyes. You don't have much longer to wait. Everything you're suffering right now is going to the Father's throne as a fast offering for last-minute conversions. So please take it to heart. It's not that we don't care about you. We care deeply. But if we stop what we're supposed to be doing to answer you, we'll never finish it, and thousands of others will not receive the comfort they need after the rapture. That's basically it. I can't take any more personal requests right now. But I do have a group of seasoned warriors that will be able to pray and advise you on the comments page or on the message page. The help you don't get from us, the Lord will give you. And I'm not just saying that. When Ezekiel and I cried out to him for the stack of letters that we had after we'd read them, the Lord said, I'm taking care of them. So he is with you, and he's going to take care of whatever it is that's going on in your life right now that's causing so much grief. Please press into the Lord. He is there for you. If I tried to answer you, I would do the same thing. I'd press into the Lord. And he's taught us to do this with the Bible promises and scripture. And I would have to do the same thing that I'm asking you to do. And Holy Spirit has your answers. I don't. So that said, please don't be upset with me. I'm just telling you the bare bones truth. A month ago, I could have answered you, but now I can't. There is no more time left, heart dwellers. We are truly on the verge of a tribulation. I saw these giant doors of mercy, and they are slowly swinging into the position of being shut. And what is left on the outside is suffering beyond our comprehension. The Lord needs your prayers now, more than ever. He needs your fast offerings now. He needs your repentance for the world now. I don't know how many different ways I can say it. There's no more time. And when I came into prayer, the Lord held me to his heart, and I just cried and cried, not really knowing the specifics and exactly why, except somehow my spirit has been shown what's about to happen. And I've been given a glimpse of how serious it really is. And I just keep weeping and telling Jesus, I'm so sorry you have to do this. I'm so sorry. And as I was being held by him and I was crying, soon he began to weep too. And then several angels stepped forward and surrounded us to bring us comfort. He began to speak. Yes, the reality of it is terribly daunting. There are things I must keep from your eyes. So terrible are they. Yes, time is up. The horrible reality is upon us. Oh, Clare, I wish you didn't have to go through this with me. I so wish I could deliver you out of this world before the worst of it hits. I wish you hadn't been born at this time, but you were, and you've been created for such a time as this. Stay in prayer, my love, and don't let anything carry you off. And I just want to make an aside here and say that he's not saying that we're going through the tribulation. What he's saying is we're going to see the beginning of it, and that in itself is going to be just horrendous. He continued, "Do only the designated tasks I have laid before you. Everyone and everything else I will take care of." As I rested my head on his heart and he held me ever so tightly, I began to see blood, pools of blood and more blood everywhere. It's almost as though those bodies just melted into pools of blood. Then I saw fire, bodies lying on the ground, burning and burning. I saw a Korean woman, alive and burning, calling out for someone. She's lifted her head and called out. A child was lying near her, dead. She collapsed and died as well. The skies were thick with smoke. I'm looking at a city on the bay, reminiscent of Oakland, California, but not necessarily that city. This city is some kind of a shipping port. I just keep seeing fireballs of debris falling from the sky, leaving a trail of smoke behind them. They look like the shattered remnants of a passing comet or volcanic eruptions coming from the sky, coming from out of nowhere. It seemed that the city was totally quiet because everyone was dead. Everyone. I cried out, "Mercy, Lord, mercy." And a quiet voice came from behind my left shoulder where my guardian angel is usually stationed. And the voice said, "The time of mercy is over, Clare. This is God's judgment on this evil and corrupt world." Then I said, "Please, Lord, say something to me." He began, "What is there to say except utter devastation to the cities of the world? One by one they will fall, beginning in the east and coming across Europe to your country. What can I say except that the time of mercy has come to an end? Pray for mercy. On my eternal clock face there are only seconds remaining. Pray much for mercy before the door has completely been sealed shut." "But Lord, your mercy is never ending." "This is true. My mercy never fails. Never. But the harvest is ripe, and the sickle is sharpened, and I will have an end to sin. Yes, I will have a complete end to sin. Oh, Clare, what I am showing you are those nations that are marked for destruction. Yours is among them. The world will not be recognizable when Satan has had his way with it. Nothing that was will remain but charred remnants and utter chaos." Jesus, I feel so sick inside. "Nevertheless, you must rally yourself while there's still a bit of time and finish what I've given you to do, Clare. Finish it. You've allowed distractions to have their way with you. Now I am asking you not to allow another distraction. Buckle down and work. Please, my beloved, it is so important to me." And, you know, at that point when the Lord said that, I mean, I was just weak. I'd been crying, and I was just empty and just as weak as I could be. And I said, Jesus, please give me some strength and clarity. After I asked him for that, all of a sudden, my empty, pain-racked heart began beating again with new strength. The anointing rose up. He's going to help me. I could feel it. Oh, saints of God, pray your chaplets of mercy. Make your fast offerings. Seek the Lord with all your heart. Seek him with all your strength. Don't focus on your problems right now. They're nothing compared to what is coming. We're used to being secure in this country and having what we need, but the whole world is about to be thrown into chaos. There's no more time for selfish thinking. Back up the Lord with your prayers. Focus on those he is about to lose forever. Please do this. This is where his heart is aching the most. Get your mind off your problems. If you must have a meditation, imagine those who have lived in suffering and have not found or responded to Jesus. Imagine that they are planning a life ahead of them or expecting something good to happen, but the jaws of hell have opened and are heading wide open for them. Behind them stand demons with pitchforks pushing them right into the abyss. Imagine now that the person who just fell into that abyss was your own son or daughter, and you will never see them again. Do you see how critical this is? Pray and offer sacrifices that they might be saved even at the last minute. And if you have issues that must be addressed, press into the Lord and expect him to act. Review our teachings on getting a word from God and get busy. You're adults now. You and Holy Spirit can work it out together. He's right there with you, just waiting for your full attention. And understand that there's very little time left. Hang on. Things are coming to an end and they're wrapping up. Trust in the Lord with all your heart and lean not on your own understanding.